बहुत सारी बातें आप लोगों ने की हैं, मैं कुछ मतलब खास कहने की स्थिति में नहीं हूँ। सिर्फ हम जो पुरानी किताबों में पढ़ते रहे हैं कि अगर आप एक पेड़ नहीं लगाते हैं तो आपको मोक्ष नहीं मिलता है, अगर आप अपने जीवन में कमतम अगर आपने एक पेड़ नहीं लगाया है तो आप ये मान के चलो कि पृथ्वी के ऋण से आप मुक्त नहीं हैं। तो अगर आप कुछ नहीं कर सकते हो तो कहीं एक पेड़ लगाओ, पेड़ नहीं लगाओ तो पेड़ को काटो मत, अगर पेड़ को काटते नहीं हो तो कम से कम उसको पानी दो, कुछ तो करो। अगर तुमने एक पत्ते को भी पानी दिया है तो मान के चलो कि तुमने नेचर को कुछ दिया है। और मुझे नहीं लगता कि अगर आपके पास नेचर नहीं होगा, अगर आप सीमेंट के शहर में रह रहे हैं तो आप ये मान के चलो कि एक दिन आप अपने आप खत्म होंगे, आपकी पीढ़ियाँ अपने आप जाएंगी। तो आप अपने लिए नहीं करो, अपने फ्यूचर के लिए कुछ करो। हमारे यहाँ एक गांव में लोग कहावत कहते हैं कि हम पैसा अपने लिए कमाते हैं लेकिन हम पेड़ लगाते हैं अपने बच्चों के लिए। तो आप अपने लिए कुछ मत करो, आप अपने बच्चों के लिए एक पेड़ लगाओ, बाकी चीज़ें दूसरे लेवल पर होंगी। अगर आपने इतना कर दिया तो चीज़ें जुड़ते जुड़ते आपका ये नेचर, आपकी ये पृथ्वी, आपका ये प्लानेट सुरक्षित रहेगा। और अगर ये प्लानेट सुरक्षित रहेगा तो मानवता का इतिहास भी सुरक्षित रहेगा, उसका भविष्य भी सुरक्षित रहेगा। और मैं चाहूँगा आप लोग ये किताबें पढ़ें, ये विचार पढ़ें। लोकेश जी ने जिसको हाईलाइट किया, बने सिंह जी ने जो किया है, पवन ने जो बातें कही हैं, उसको ध्यान में रख करके इस किताब को पढ़ा जाए, इनके विचारों को आगे बढ़ाया जाए। मुझे लगता है इससे अच्छी भूमिका कुछ हो नहीं सकती आपकी। धन्यवाद आप सब।
थैंक यू वेरी मच डॉक्टर बॉडी, थैंक यू वेरी मच पवन फॉर योर कमेंट्स एंड व्यूज। एंड अब वक्त आ गई है फॉर व्हाट यू हैव बीन वेटिंग फॉर ऑल इवनिंग टू हियर इट फ्रॉम द ऑथर हिमसेल्फ। सो बने सिंह जी, आई एम गोइंग टू ऑफर इट टू यू, एंड वी हैव जस्ट बीन वेटिंग एंग्शियसली होल इवनिंग टू हियर फ्रॉम यू अबाउट योर वर्क। सो प्लीज टेक ऑल द टाइम एंड वी आर एंग्शियसली वेटिंग एंड लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड फॉर योर व्यूज।
थैंक यू। चीफ गेस्ट श्री लोकेश सिंह जी साहिब, श्री पवन शंकर जी साहिब, आई एक्सप्रेस इमेंस ग्रेटिट्यूड फ्रॉम द नॉर्थ वेस्ट कॉर्नर ऑफ माई हार्ट फॉर स्पेयरिंग अ फ्यू मोमेंट्स आउट ऑफ देयर हेक्टिक एंड टाइट शेड्यूल एंड ब्राइटनिंग ऑफ दिस इवेंट विद देयर ग्रेशियस प्रेजेंस, ग्लोरियस फिगर्स एंड टावरिंग पर्सनालिटीज दैट दे आर इन देयर रेस्पेक्टिव फील्ड्स। लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, I ardently wish to thank kindly all of you for coming in your numbers to witness this momentous occasion. Before I proceed, I want to give glory and adoration to the Almighty God of Heaven and Mother Earth for helping me conclude this mammoth project to a logical end. Further, I express my deep sense of gratitude to my esteemed leader publishers, Lead Star Publishing, for reposing faith in me and my book. Consequently upon, they generously ventured to bring out this book solely dedicated to a nobler and higher cause of environmental awareness. In this regard, I also want to further thank to Crossword Bookstores and DeCosta, Honorable Mr. Swarup Nanda, Mr. Apuva for the wonderful organizational work they together carried out to bring this function into being. Now, one may want to ask me to what motivated me to write the book we have just launched. Okay, well, after completing B in civil engineering in 1998, I developed massive penchant towards environment and ecology during 91-92 and completed course in ecology, environment and ecology during the same time. Since then, I kept on enriching my environmental knowledge and started closely tracking national international issues. In June 2008, I got the groovy opportunity to become the assistant director of Divisional Environmental Cell Water Resources that opened the floodgates, and I was exposed to the plethora of environmental information. I immensely contributed in framing several environmental reports and comprehensive volumes, dozens of that. During the same time, I started contributing full-length articles on environment and pollution in the Times of India Special Supplement that received much acclaim. I also took part in a very high profile nationwide campaign, namely Citizen Connect Initiative, and put forward novel and innovative ideas for the environmental enhancement. I was adjudged national grand winner in that contest held in late 2009, thereafter accorded tour to the chosen and most livable cities of Europe. During the middle of 2009, the idea struck to me, why not reach the entire world by means of writing a book? I also perceived a great vacuum that was there because I didn't come across a single book which systematically dealt with all environmental issues and global initiatives bearing diagnostic and prescription combined in one. So that was a great vacuum, and that inspired me to write a book that will bear all the diagnostic and cure. Well, when God Almighty in His grace puts the spirit of writing into a person, one can hardly resist the urge to write for long. However, the path to success is not without shortfalls and hardship, but with firm determination and from my own point of view, the divine afflatus once bestowed upon any individual, the success will come his way, provided if he perseveres. I will drink the ocean and at my will, mountain will crumble. Having that sort of tremendous passion, that sort of wonderful spirit of patience, along with unflinching zeal and staunch will, I accomplished this monumental purpose in a whopping 3 years. It was like searching elusive Higgs boson, the subatomic God particle, which has been searched recently, 1 week back. Searching and filtering millions of data and reaching a logical conclusion to emphasize any point of view which was propounded in the book. I extensively traveled to many cities, both in India and abroad, to get the first-hand information about the state of environment, level of environment, level of awareness, conservation measures. Even I went to Mount Atlas, 10,000 feet higher, and I got the first-hand information how the glaciers are retreating, how the glaciers are melting. So actually, I have tried my best to get the first-hand information. You will find a lot of first-hand pictures taken by me. I took at least 1,000 pictures, and I have tried my best to give first-hand information. Fruit of that arduous journey is in front of the entire globe in the form of an excellent work as TBP, Healing the Blue Planet, and Informed Consent. Far and away, the best prize for that life has to offer is the chance to work hard, to work that is worth doing. By the divine enjoyment, I got this opportunity that was to be seized and worth doing, to write an upbeat and innovative book in order to spread environmental awareness and disseminating information about raging environmental issues across the planet. It did not take long before I sat down to write my next book, at least on my computer. And my wife could only wonder at the resilient spirit of the person she has chosen to share her life with. If the Creator permits me, this will not be the last book I will launch in the future. Yes, indeed, those who admire my writing and me should look out for more books from this humble mid-sized city dweller in the near future.